thinking to the future, we know the climate is warming. We have to ask ourselves, how are the trees we're planting today going to cope with those warming environments of the future?
I'd like government to bring its departments together and have a coherent, concerted plan to support nature.
That we should stop siloing forestry in one place and agriculture in another and other land uses in another, but start thinking about cohesive landscapes where forestry and agriculture are mixed together into one ecological unit.
There needs to be a recognition that forestry is not just cutting and planting trees. It's also the enjoyment of woods, the education that can take place, and the other activities which are forest-based.
We've persuaded government on several areas of policy in principle. Now they need to deliver on funding and hard policy in practice.
Timber and paper products is one of our biggest imports in the UK. And if you can grow quality timber that gets turned into quality products, that carbon in those trees is locked up for a very, very long time. And this is so important today when we're trying to hit our net carbon targets.
I'd like to see the government put its money where its mouth is, really. It talks about climate crisis and using timber more in projects. But I'd like to see it have a Growninbritain first policy on all of the projects that are funded by taxpayers' money, whether it's building a new school or in Parliament buildings, local authorities, highways, all of these things that are funded by the public purse. They should have a Growninbritain first policy.
I think the 19% canopy cover across the UK by 2050 is an achievable target. So if the government was to put out clear messaging of all landowners, farmers, and communities increasing canopy cover between 5 and 10% and supporting that directly financially, then that would bring about the kind of canopy cover that we need in this country.
And if you had to make one policy suggestion to government, what would it be?
Put some serious investment into helping solve the grey squirrel problem. Grey squirrels will damage planted trees, they will damage naturally regenerated trees, they damage a wide array of our native species, and they fundamentally frustrate the kind of the woody economy from being the brilliant sustainable industry that it can be when we haven't got grey squirrel damage.
I'd probably say a carbon tax because so much of the way, so many of the problems that we have are connected with cheap fossil energy. But it would really incentivise people to be producing food and other products, such as woodland products, locally in the landscape.
In other European countries, where they're planting trees for timber and there is improved material available, they have to plant that by law. And I think my one policy suggestion would be that this should be the same in the UK.
So I'd like the Education Department to sort out the fact that every school child in Britain should have access to forest school.
My main contribution is to suggest that woodland restoration is given a priority over planting, and all planting is made to have a decent planting plan and management plan. Because without that, we're just going to have more neglected woodlands.